expensive rings and things. I bring them things. I bring them things. I bring them things.
Man, you don't want what them, bro. Oh, you, any better get low. Extorting, you ain't got no friends. Oh, they'll be for that like a Chanel scarf like rainbow. $1,000, this ain't your cloth. You ain't, that ain't no sauce. I can see the noodles made for poodles. I'm thinking about the LaFerrari coupe. 1.8, the option is the roof. Greens is a secret to the youth. Your goals are malnourished, please spit the juice. Y'all be vaping, I be laden. Yes, y'all be aping, I'm Richard Mill Nation. No diamonds, just tourbillon facing with gears and sprockets with the sapphire casing.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA
Sports. All right, Larry, thanks. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, Mass. Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Oakland Raiders and the New England Patriots. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. Marshawn Lynch, and running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down. Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. On second down, Lynch. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. He lost two there, and it's third down.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs, and let's face it, they know how to finish plays too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
To throw, it's Carr. And now the ball's out. Carr lost it, fumble, and it's picked up by the Patriots. And he will score. Touchdown, Patriots. And give some kudos to the defensive coordinator, I think, here. They bring the blitz, they dial it up, and it turns into 6 points for them.
It's so nice to hear you actually give kudos to the defense. It is so nice to such an offensive guy like that. I love it. He dialed things up, and boy, a big play resulted for his guys.
Well, you like the credit to the defense there, right, my friend?
Yeah, do I ever.
So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. CD, I want to get your thoughts on some potential free agents this offseason before we change the possession here. Now, caution, many of these guys could be resigned, I know, but who are some of them? Kirk Cousins is one.
Yeah, we're talking about difference makers. Kirk Cousins at the quarterback position, he's going to be coveted around the league by quarterback needy teams. Case Keenum had a big year. Could he move? But how about running backs? Le'Veon Bell, Deion Lewis. Some pass catchers, Jimmy Graham, Jarvis Landry, Sammy Watkins, and about the guy who goes and gets quarterbacks. DeMarcus Lawrence had a monster year for Dallas last season.
Yeah, a lot of big names that could be out there as free agents. And he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to the 40-yard line. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that and have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
Well, that play was doomed right from the start.
They just about ran into every defender on that one, didn't he? It felt like everyone got a piece of that tackle.
And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
They're on the march, but facing a third down here. throwing his car on third down. Cooper's got it. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line. They've got another first down. The Raider passing game clicking on all cylinders right now. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
You need your wide receivers as blockers. Sometimes they get a hold.
The big runs are often a result of what they do on the perimeter. In this case, got caught holding, and this one will come back.
Now a play fake here on first down. Looking for the end zone. And this is caught by Cooper for a Raider touchdown. Amari Cooper, 29 yards. And the Raiders, they're within an extra point of tying this thing up. And it was a tight window. He knew he had to rocket that thing in there. He got it done.
And when you're able to complete one like that, your confidence has to just go sky high. You just mentioned it. Tight window, zings it in there despite excellent coverage. Result, touchdown.
This fielded a few yards into the end zone. Oh, nice move. Oh, and now he bowls him over. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Game clock at 2:01. Time for one final play before the two-minute warning. On first and 10, here's Brady. He's going to wind up and air it out. He's got a man complete. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Larry Ridley is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. And that's going to be caught for a Patriot touchdown. Chris Hogan, 39 yards. And the Patriots have taken the lead. And when a Hail Mary is completed for a touchdown pass like that, I think any defensive coordinator just puts their face right into their hands.
I don't think there's any doubt about it, and I don't have stats in front of me. I don't have the empirical numbers that say that in recent years the Hail Mary pass has been completed more than it has been, but it feels that way, doesn't it? And I know the defenses are spending more time on it. I think the biggest mistake they make is that they play everything from behind the receiver. I think they've got to start getting people in front as well to try and knock the ball away.
The New England defense gearing up to take the field. Obviously a close game from the defensive standpoint. Maybe don't want to blow it too much out of proportion, but how important is this drive?
I think it's huge for them because they've got to find a way to help out their offense. Whether it's...
And now the ball's out. Carr lost it. Fumble. And it's picked up by the Patriots. And he's into the end zone. It's a fumble return and a Patriot touchdown. So that is now two fumble return touchdowns. And you talk about something that's going to drive a head coach crazy.
Without a doubt. But for the defensive guys, once you do it once, you create a frenzy. Everybody wants to get involved, and they got it done a second time.
So not only the cough up, but then the pickup on the other side, the scoop, and the score the other way, the fumble return for a touchdown. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kicks away following that fumble return. On the return, here's the dangerous Cordarrelle Patterson. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Before the offense changes hands here, let's look back at the Super Bowl February 5th. What a game. I know you were there calling it offensively, though. Impressive on both sides.
It certainly was, and let's face it, if you're in Minnesota, it's cold outside, but you talk about the offenses, they heated up in a big way. And how about Nick Foles, the backup quarterback turned MVP, 373 yards, three touchdowns, and of course, the big one receiving on the Philly special.
Quite a story. As you and I were talking about off air, it was just a fluid game, not a lot of penalties, just really clean play.
Exactly. exactly the type of game the NFL needed for the audiences at home watching the game and, of course, people in attendance. A really well-played game.
And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. Give him 8 on the play, and that'll bring up a 3rd and 1. Carr going to try and throw on 3rd down. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football, and it's picked up by the Patriots. And they are going to take over right there at the 22-yard line.
Brandon, that's the 3rd time he's fumbled so far in this game. And, you know, you can make excuses for each and every one of them, but the bottom line is he's got to take care of it better. And now that he's shown a propensity for fumbling it, just think about what the defenders are trying to do.
Yeah, well, guys hate 1 fumble, 2s, oh, my goodness, 3 or more. Wow.
Just doesn't make any sense, does it?
Want to give a hat tip. And this is caught. Touchdown, Patriots. Danny Amendola, a 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Patriots add 6 to their lead. Well, that didn't take long. The turnover instantly almost turning into points.
And when that happens, a lot of teams have the mentality of let's strike right now. You've got them off balance after the turnover or the takeaway. Let's go get it. And that's exactly what they did.
Well, they got the ball in great field position. 1 play later, boom, end zone. Gostkowski now out to kick it away. This fielded at the 2. Oh, look at the juke. But before the possession switches here, I had written down that I wanted to talk about some of the awards this past season in the NFL. We know Brady was the MVP, but Todd Gurley, Offensive Player of the Year.
How about that for a bounce back? Many were questioning whether he'd had a sophomore slump the season before. Didn't even get to 1,000 yards. Was a dominant force in 2017. How about his teammate Aaron Donald on the defensive side? He took home Defensive Player of the Year award.
Yeah, very impressive. They had both sides of the ball. Sean McVay deserving, I think you would agree, of Coach of the Year.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, what he did for the Rams when they went from last in the league in scoring to leading the league in scoring and winning a division title. And how about the New Orleans Saints, Rookie of the Year, offense and defense. Alvin Kamara on offense, Marshawn Lattimore on defense.
And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4th.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
And now Edelman. Flag comes in as they got him down via the face mask, and that'll give him even better starting position.
Personal foul, face mask, defense.
So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it is going to be 15 yards.
And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. Right. The final shot before half for Brady. Flush to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep. And that's going to be caught for a Patriot touchdown. Brandon Cooks as time expires in the first half. And the Patriots add on to their lead. And just before the half ends, the prayer is answered defensively. A disaster there.
I know often we're surprised when this actually works. I mean, the excitement level goes way up, but maybe we shouldn't be, because I know as a defender, you've got to play the ball in this situation, but you can't interfere with the receiver because, remember, it's a spot foul, and it'd be 1st and goal if it happens in the end zone, and you don't want to give up that play. And that little bit of hesitancy often works really well for offensive guys.
play of game, offense.
And the first half, just like the end of the game, can't end with a defensive penalty. They'll have another play.
One more play, untimed. See what happens here.
Delay of game, offense.
And that'll set them back five.
Delay of game, offense.
Yeah, that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back five.
Delay of game, offense.
So that'll back him up five. And now this will be the final play of the half, as with no time remaining, they'll try and add two more to the lead right before intermission. The final shot before break. Brady. And he slings one that's incomplete. So we've reached halftime here at Gillette Stadium with the Patriots on top, as we'll send you down the coast to Orlando where we... Sorry, Larry, your hard work appreciated by so many men and women, but not today as we get back to the action in the second half. That's fielded in the end zone. Shifts by him. They find some open field here. And all the way in, touchdown, New England. Deion Lewis, 104 yards. And the Patriots are pouring it on. And people still trying to get back to their seats from the concession stand here at the start of the third quarter, and boom, we got points on the board.
And you just identified why the bulk of stadiums have increased presence in the concession areas, right? TVs, loudspeakers, so people can still follow the game. And right now, they're bummed out that they missed that big return to start this half.
So now the other return teams out there as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw. This is taken at the three. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Carr gonna throw to the right side. He's got Cooper. It's complete. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. A gain of six there on first. Second down now after the pass completion. Carr gives to Marshawn. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a third down and two.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right. He's pretty much been completely neutralized. They'll run it. Here's Lynch. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively, and it likely forces a punt situation on fourth. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it was the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
And problems spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly. The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away.
Yeah,
defense,
we got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see if the offense gets done.
The throw left side complete to Hogan. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That goes for a gain of 31. On first down, Brady. And some room to work. He'll wind up getting nine after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with second and a yard. Now Brady throwing on second down. And his throw here is incomplete. Danny Amendola, the man he was trying to get it to. And it's third and short.
This defense could use some more of these types of plays. How about him reading it, driving on the football, and he's right there for the pass breakup.
Brady to throw on third and one. Escaping the pressure right. He can run for it, and he will. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third. Back now in Foxborough, and this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. His throw caught at about the five, and all the way down inside the five to the four. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down to throw. It's Brady, and they are going to score. Again, yet another touchdown as they just added their totals. So another score there. Often you talk about the three phases of the game. Defense, offense, special teams. It's been a clean sweep in this one, hasn't it?
It certainly has. They've been pretty dominant throughout this game. And privately, the head coach will add a fourth phase That's the coaching. And he'll tell the ownership that as he tries to negotiate a new contract off of this win.
They are looking strong here in the fourth quarter. Gostkowski now out to kick it away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Now Carr throwing on second down. This one left side caught by Patterson. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Carr fighting Patterson there for a Raider first. So it's Raider football as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. Carr now on first down. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, David Harris. And they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent. And now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
Amendola's got it complete. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
You have fun with this one, partner.
I am. He's been fun to watch under center.
We always talk about, you know, getting to the next level, right? When we see people get into the zone, this guy's in the master class right now. What a performance he's putting on, just carving them up.
Four touchdown passes, carving them up is right. Seems like everything he throws is going to be a completion and going in the end zone. Gostkowski now out to kick it away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And now Oakland ready to take the field. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And the coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
And complete right side to Cook. Cook stripped, the ball's out. And it's picked up by the Patriots. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line.
And with that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes. But it's been pretty symptomatic of what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget, absolutely. Brady going to look to throw. Going for the deep ball. And nearly picked it off. He had a chance to come down with that in the end zone, but it'll wind up just being incomplete. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you can put yourself in jeopardy.
And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. He turned that into a nice gain, gets him 8 yards closer for third down. Brady looking to throw on third and two. Give him another six. It's caught for a touchdown, and the blowout continues.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. Extra point try for Gostkowski. Thank you. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. The drive there only spanning three plays. And it ends with a New England touchdown. Gostkowski now out to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And now Oakland ready to take the field. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo
exactly.
Going forward.
Exactly. Take a great.
And now off to the races down the right side. And somewhat of a measure of revenge as he's in for the touchdown, but they still trail big time.
He'll take it, but he won't be able to smile about it. And yeah, that touchdown counts for their team, but I think it counts more for the fantasy guys, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's just some. Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked. It's picked up. Accelerating, and off he goes. He's at the 40. Past the 20. And he dives into the end zone and gets the 2 points. And I don't know that fumble's going to matter a whole lot. You look at the deficit here in the fourth, it doesn't matter. The coach on the sideline's still scratching his head.
Yeah, not only scratching his head, but probably writing a note or two about, we're going to address this come practice next week because maybe that's the reason we're down this far. Doesn't matter at this point, but being sloppy throughout the game, not going to help him improve.
Now the Patriots gearing up to go now. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, in the 2015 season,
Rob Gronkowski, there he goes! And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
I've got a laugh here, and I really don't want to because the old school in me is not happy about this score this late, not necessary. But this is Madden, isn't it?
Yeah.
This is how it works.
Rub it in. Have a day.
I mean, what does it matter? These guys who are playing in this game, there are no feelings.
Exactly.
There.
They don't have to face the guy. Well, they might if they're in the same room going head-to-head.
But that's
the
about
virtual
it.
Guys on the screen don't have to face each other after this one.
In that case, run it up.
Gostkowski now out to kick it away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and he'll take over at the 25. Throwing on first down, it's Carr. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just.
And now the ball's out. Carr lost it. Fumble. And it's picked up by the Patriots. And this drive will start on the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line.
Well, partner, they went empty set there. No backs in the backfield. All receivers out in the pattern. And in this situation, you know what the quarterback has to do? Act as his own blitz control.
Yeah, he's got nobody else there to protect.
No one else there to protect, which means he's got to get rid of the football and absorb the hit, but not go down and fumble the ball.
It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal. Brady going to throw here, eluding the pressure right. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be second down. Now we'll get whistles, and they've signaled for a timeout. Not sure I see the logic in this, but we'll get a stoppage anyway with 5 seconds remaining. And this looks to probably be the final play. They'll run for it with Deion Lewis. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. I tell you, Charles, You play to the final whistle, I get that. But there are a few folks that might not be too happy with that score late in the game with it already well in hand.
You seem a little squeamish about that last score.
I struggle with it. I struggle. But on the other, the argument, I get it, on the other side is, hey, do something about it. Stop them.
I guarantee you, I know it was really excited. Fantasy owners who had them. Hey, listen, get the points for me. They're not worried about hurt feelings or anything like that. That's just new age stuff.
And the hands team for the Raiders able to secure it. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're